Okay, good morning class. Today we are going to start HTML. So let us understand what HTML is. HTML basically stands for Hypertext Markup Language. HTML is a computer language which is used to create web pages or websites which can be later published on the web, which makes it possible to present your content, whatever you are putting on your web page, that will be available for everyone, on those who are using the internet. They can visit your site, they can visit your content, they can visit whatever you have written over there. HTML always uses predefined words that are known as tags for the creation of web pages. You cannot create any of the word and you cannot make it as a tag from your own wish, because we have only predefined tags which we can use in HTML. Now, what are these tags? Tags are basically these are the instructors that instruct web browser where to put things and how they will appear on the web page. Like suppose if I'm writing a paragraph on my web page, then what will be the appearance of that paragraph? Like whether it will be a red in color, or what will be the font color, what will be the font size of that paragraph, everything related to that paragraph, how it will appear on the web page, it will be decided by the tags. Tags always begins with left angle bracket and ends with right angle bracket, like this. In between the tag, the word which we place is known as the tag name. Like HTML, we are putting the left angle bracket and the right angle bracket, and in between we are putting HTML. So HTML is the tag name, and angle because we are putting the angle bracket both left angle bracket also and right angle bracket also, so it becomes a tag now. One more thing you have to keep remember, that there should not be any space between angle bracket and the word which you are writing. If there will be a space, it will not be considered as a tag. Next is, now what are the features of HTML tags? Tags begins with always left angle bracket and ends with right angle bracket. The word between the bracket is known as the tag name. Tags are not case sensitive. Not case sensitive means it doesn't matter whether you write in capital letters or write in small letters, or you write half of the word in capital and half of the word in small. It doesn't matter at all, because HTML is not a case sensitive language. Now, tags are of two different tags have two different parts. One is the opening tag and one is closing tag. We always write opening tag like this, and for closing tag we have to put a forward slash before writing the word. Again, there will be no space between angle bracket and the forward slash and the word. It should be in continuation only. Next is, what are the different types of tags? We have two different types of tags. One is container tag and one is empty tag. Container tag. Now, what is container tag? Container tags are those tags which have opening as well as closing. It means if you are opening the container tags, it is compulsory to close them also. Because if you will not close the container tags, the effect of the tag which you have opened will remain throughout. So it is compulsory to close the tags at the end, where you want the effect should disappear or effect should not continue. Next is empty tag. Empty tags are those tags which have opening but there is no closing. For example, paragraph tag and break tag. These tags are also called as standalone tags. Now, what are attributes? Attributes means the properties. For example, if I'm talking about car, then what are the properties of car? Means how many wheels it have, and what is the color of the car, what is the brand of the car. These are the properties of a car. Similarly, if I'll talk about tags in HTML, then the properties of that tag will be whether that means, suppose it's a paragraph tag, that the content of this paragraph will be left side or right side or center or top or bottom. What type of alignment will it have? It can be in any way. So align is the attribute here of paragraph tag, because it is telling something extra, some more information about the paragraph tag. Next is structure of HTML document. Structure of HTML document, whenever we start an HTML document, it is compulsory to use four tags for every document. And what are these four tags? First is HTML tag. HTML tag will always be the first and the last tag. Means it will open, it will get open in the beginning and it will get closed at the end of the document only. Next is head tag. Head tags contain information about the web page. Means whatever the content you will write inside head tag will become the heading of your page. Next is title tag. Title tag always comes inside the head tag. This tag contains the information about the page only, but whatever the content you will write inside the title tag will become the title of your browser. If you are using Google Chrome, then it will become the title of your browser. Next is body tag. Body tag. Now, whatever the content you will write inside the body tag, it will get displayed on the web page. It means whatever you want to display on your web page, that you have to write only inside the body tag. Okay, now let us understand how to create the web page. For this, you can use any of the text editor. It can be a notepad, it can be a WordPad, it can be anything. You have to write the coding in that and then save it and then open it on the browser. For example, I'm starting with the basic code of HTML first. That is HTML, head, then title will come. Then you have to write the title of the page for the browser. Close title tag, close head tag. Body tag, close body, and close HTML. This is the basic structure of HTML, and this structure will remain same for all the pages of HTML. Doesn't matter that whether you are creating the links on the page, whether you are inserting the images on the page, whether you are creating the forms in HTML, whatever you are doing on HTML, this structure will always remain same for every question. But here, the title which I have written, it may get changed according to your question. For example, if you are creating a page of linking, then you can write this title as linking. If you are creating a page with images, you can write this title as images. Whatever it means, this title will become the title of your web page only. Now here on my page, I'm just writing, hi, this is my first web page. And now how to save it? Press Ctrl plus S. Then choose the location where you want to save your page. I'm saving it with my page.html. Now this extension .html is compulsory to use for every web page. If you will not use this extension .html, then your page will be saved as a notepad only or a text editor only, not as a web page. So it is compulsory to use the extension my web page. Now I'm going to create a new folder where I'm going to save it. And I'm going to save it here. Now let us check and open and check the folder HTML practicals. Okay, we have saved it here. Inside HTML, there is a folder HTML practicals. And this is my page. Now I'm opening it with Google Chrome. Okay, so I have written only one line in my web on my web page, that is, hi, this is my first web page, and I have also inserted a title as welcome. So here it is coming, welcome. This will become the title of the web browser, and whatever you will write inside the body, it will become the part of your web page, content of your web page. So whatever you want to display on your web page, that you have to always write inside the body tag between the opening and the closing of body tag. And whatever you want to make the title of your browser, you have to write it here between the title, opening and closing. So this is a basic structure of HTML. It will always starts with HTML and the document will get closed with closing of HTML only, and then second tag will be head, third tag will be title, then you have to write the title of the page, then title close, head close, body start, now write your content, then close body, and then close HTML. So this is how you can create a simple web page.